Hey guys, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you again. My name is Promise Bale from Promise Recording Studio. I'm here to do a tutorial on how to record a full backup vocals, especially for gospel producers. I don't like wasting people's time. Can we just dive right into Cubase? All right, this is my Cubase. I have a project here tied to the crown. There are three things I do. Number one, I do multiple takes. And here's the reason why I do multiple takes. If you sing the same thing again, it sounds a bit different. You sing it again, sounds a bit different. Again, I mean the voice texture. So when those textures add up, you get a different, fuller kind of sound. You understand? So when those textures add up, you start getting a crowdy response gradually. Now, this is another question. Okay, what if I decide to record one and duplicate it? What we have is volume increment, and you will not be able to achieve that. So what I did here was simple. It depends on the song I am recording. Sometimes if I am working with a single backup vocalist, what I will do is I will create more tracks because it is one person. Then I will do 6 takes each, but this is 5. Sometimes I love to do even numbers, sometimes I love to do odd numbers for the purpose of panning. So if I'm recording with one person, I'll create multiple tracks, then I'll color them to be able to differentiate alto, soprano, and tenor. As you can see here, I have five sopranos. So it depends on the number of vocalists you are working with. Depends on the number of vocalists you are working with. So if you are working with one vocalist, you want to do multiple takes. You can do 6 each. 6 soprano, 6 alto, and 6 tenor. So that by the time you start to pan them, you get that feel. Let's assume you're working with 1 soprano, 1 alto, and 1 tenor. I will advise you to do 4 takes, because you're not working with 3 voice texture, 3 different voice texture. You're working with the thicker voice texture, which is the male, and 2 feminine voices. It's more like making do with what you have. So without wasting time, let's get right into our Cubase. All right, now let me play this job, not mixed.
I hope you'll be ready when he comes. I hope you decide whose side you're on. There is a race I must run. There are battles to be won. Lord, lead me through till the end.
Okay, if you listen to this backup, you will notice it was done by one person. But you can't deny the fact that it's sounding, you can't deny it. But you can't deny the fact that, you know, it's sounding a bit robust, a bit fuller than those regular kind of singing. So what I did here was simple. Number one, I took 5 takes each. 5 soprano, 5 alto, and 5 tenor. Then the panning did the job more, and the bit of spreading. So let me just show you what I did here quickly. Okay, let me show you what I did here. So you can see this is the first take. So I'll record this. So I'll take the first take. I'll take second take, the same thing, and they must all follow the same timing. I'll take the third take to the fifth take. I'll come back to the alto and take the same, and to the tenor I'll take the same. After you've gotten your recording, the next thing you want to look at is your panning. The panning does the job. So what I normally do is, you can do what works for you. Some producers prefer to carry all sopranos to one side, all altos to one side, and leave the tenor at the middle, or they have the thicker voice at the middle. It's fine. Now for the first track, first soprano track, I will take it to the left. I always love to take it to the left. I'll press L, then I'll give it 90. If I'm doing another panning of any kind of instrument, be it guitar or anything that wants to pan, I will pan it close to 90. Then I will take soprano 2 left, 85. So this, I will take this same to left, 80% to the left. Then I will take soprano 4 to the right, 75% to the right. Then soprano 5, 70%, 70% to the right also. Now I will come back to the alto, but this time I will channel the first auto 90% to the right. Don't forget, my first soprano was 90%, second one was 85, and the top soprano was 80. Three sopranos to the left, three altos to the right, were the same panning ratio to the right. Now we come to auto 1, 90, auto 2, 85, then auto 3, 90, 85, and auto 3 is 80 to the right. Then auto 4, we go to the left, 75 to the left. And the last auto will go 70 to the left. Depends on what works for you. If you have more vocals, try this method. If it doesn't work, come back and call me Shaggy. Now, the tenor, what I will do for the tenor is, I will take the first tenor 1 to the left by 50%. I will take the other tenor to the right by 50%. I will leave the remaining tenor at the middle of the... I will leave the remaining 3 tenors at the middle of the mix. Now, let's hear how it sounds.
I hope you'll be ready when he comes. I hope there is a race I must run. There are battles to be won. Lord, lead.
So, that's how to achieve a full vocals. Number one, you must do multiple takes. Don't duplicate. Record multiple times. You record multiple times. That's one. Number two, prepare the vocals by panning. And number three, you start to process the vocals. That's a lecture for another day. So if you have further questions you feel like asking, please don't fear to reach me on my phone number. I'll drop it on the description below. And also, if you need this Cubase 13, you can also indicate. I'll also drop the link in the description below. Feel free to put your comment on the comment section. I'll see you again on the next tutorial on how to process this backing vocal.